Paracletus International Ministries encourages you to excel in Christ daily.
This is what it's saying. A lot of people have taken this very scripture out of context. A lot of people feel like once you get saved, you don't sin, but you do sin. And you come short. But you don't keep coming short. Because if you got the Holy Ghost will lead you in the way of righteousness if you want to be right. So therefore, those of us that are named the name of Jesus, we should sit around and conjure up that I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. And when we know what the Word of God says for us not to do. But then we want to override the Holy Ghost and override the Spirit and say, well, I'm grown, I'm on my own, and God will forgive. You playing with your salvation. Yes, God will forgive, but who knows? He may not forgive you for that particular thing that you've done. And especially when you know it's wrong. So when we say, as it is written, and we know whosoever is born of God, in other words, have a personal relationship with God. You got to have a personal relationship with God in order to have the mindset that you want to please God.
Amen.
In every sense of the word.
Amen.
Not in some things, but in everything.
Everything.
You have the mindset that you want to do what God say do.
Yeah.
Whatever it comes and whatever it takes.
Yeah.
It may hurt somebody. And as I was listening to Pastor was talking about Bill Gates, for example. Yes, a lot of people try to influence you with money.
Yeah.
Prestige and jobs and positions and everything.
Yeah.
To go against the morals and principles of God.
Yeah.
Right.
But those of us, praise God, that really have strong ties with God, we have the mindset to reject anything that come up against the word of God.
Amen.
To make us do wrong. So that's what it means when it says, whosoever is born of God sinneth not. In other words, we don't sit behind closed doors. We don't sit and try to find ways and means to detour or to deviate from what it already is written.
Amen.
Well, we know what God says, and we know what man says.
Right.
We know that the world is turning away from God because we can see the condition of this world. We can see that people are falling away from the word. They don't have no fear.
That's right.
They have no respect of God.
That's right.
They use his name in vain.
Amen.
Am I right?
Amen.
They treat people like dirt. Because they don't believe in treat others as you want to be treated. They don't believe in the golden rule.
That's right.
These are the things that God tells us not to sin against, or sin against our fellow man, but this is what we see.
Amen.
All the time.
Yeah.
And so I believe with all my heart, God allowed situations to come up in our lives to show us or to teach us, praise God, how important the word is and how important we are to each other.
Yeah.
So he allows storms and tornadoes to come through to get us on one accord.
That's right.
People don't look at color no more. They don't even look at denomination.
All right.
They don't look at whether you gay or straight.
All right.
They just need him.
Yeah,
and they don't care where it comes from, just since they get to him.
Yeah.
That's right.
They don't care, praise God, whether you love them or not. They don't care about the black power. They don't care about black lies or white lies or Jewish lies. They don't care about no but lies matter. They just see that their lives matter. Can you say amen?
Amen?
So when we look at the word of God today, it is very important, praise God, for us to understand so we can rightly divide the word of truth. And as we see, praise God, that our world, according to this scripture, is going downward, downward, down. It's spiraling down. Morals and principles is at a ground zero.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
People don't have the love and compassion for each other like they used to.
Amen.
It's just like everybody got their own agenda. Everybody got what they want to do, and what they got going on is more important than you.
Yeah.
And that should be. All of this ties in that we are not to sin against the morals and principles that God has set up for us to have for our fellow man.
Uh-huh.
And first of all, if we don't have the love and respect for God, we're not going to have love and respect for our fellow man and nobody else.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
So that's why he said, whosoever is born of God sinneth not. It doesn't mean that you don't sin and come short, but you don't keep on sinning and come short.
That's right.
In other words, praise God, you have to pray and ask God to give you the strength and give you the power so you won't be caught in that situation again.
That's right.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
So they say, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself.
Yeah.
Those of us that are naming the name of Jesus,
yeah,
we find ways and means by praying and fasting and seeking God so we can keep ourselves from the evil one, who is the devil. The devil knows just what it takes to make you fall.
Yes.
He knows just what it takes to make you sin against God. Mm-hmm. It may not take that brother, it might not take that sister, but he'll send somebody that you're attracted to make you fall.
Yeah.
You may not be attracted to money, but you might be attracted to fame.
That's right.
So whatever it takes, the devil know your heart and know your desires. He know you more than you know yourself. So he know just what it takes to make you fall.
Yes.
The Bible say David was a man after God's own heart.
Yes, he was.
Yes, he sinned against God, but he got back on the right track.
Yes.
All the wives and all the concubines he had, that wasn't enough for him, but he was out on the porch looking around and saw this woman across the palace gate bathing. And something about that woman he desired. And just like that, the devil had entered in his heart to make him sin against God. He could have stopped it. He could have saw it and turned away. But it had gotten in his heart. Once something get in your heart,
yes, Lord.
Oh, y'all better hear me.
Yes, Lord.
Then the mouth began to speak.
Yes, God.
Because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaking and tell what's really in the heart.
That's right.
And so he sent for the woman. He didn't have to send for her. We're still talking about whosoever is born of God sinneth not.
Right.
He had purpose in his heart to do just what he wanted to do with that woman when he summoned for her. He didn't have to summon, and then he found out that who she was, that she belonged to another. And that should have cut it off right then. No, I ain't going to bother that. Because that's Uriah's wife. And he's my servant. He's out on the battlefield trying to defend Jerusalem and defend the king. So I ain't going to bother her. I just mess one of my other concubines, my other wives out. I would not bother this little wee she. But he went on and did it anyhow. Do you understand what I'm saying? But let me remind you, David was still a man after God's own heart, but he sinned.
Yes, he did.
And he thought he was getting away with it.
Mm-hmm.
To make a long story short, you know, he kept sinning for her. She came, and she finally got pregnant for him and told him what had happened. When you do one thing wrong, that will lead to another thing.
There you go.
Oh, y'all don't hear me.
That's right.
That's right.
That's why I say those of us that are born of God, we don't sin. In other words, they keep on just adding sin to sin. Because the same sin you sin with, God will take that sin and whoop you with it.
Amen.
He'll whoop you with your own sin, with your own downfall. So he tried to cover up. That's another thing. When you sin, you try to cover it up. You try to conceal it. You don't want nobody to know that you done wrong. You done did this and you done did that. He might have gotten away with it had he not gotten pregnant. And when he got pregnant, he knew that her husband was on the battlefield.
Uh-huh.
Oh, y'all don't hear me.
That's right.
So he tried to cover up by off the battlefield and try to sweeten him up and tell him that he's doing a great job, but I want you to go and spend some time with your wife. But because the man was so dedicated to the cause, why should I sit at the king's table and my fellow servants, my fellow men, is out on the battlefield risking their lives for Jerusalem? He couldn't do it because his heart was right.
My God.
Do y'all hear me? Instead of him going home, he sat by David's door all night long. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Because the man had a good heart, but King David had sin in his heart. Do y'all hear me? When David woke up the next morning and found that Uriah was at his door and slept there all night long instead of going to his wife and to put that babe on him. Oh, y'all don't hear me. He was furious. Then he had to conjure up. That's what I mean by conjuring up things. He had to conjure up something else, you know, to cover his mess. So he wrote a letter to his superior. I think it was Abner. He wrote a letter to Abner and said, make sure you put Uriah on the front line to make sure he get killed.
That's right.
Put him with a heavy fire or whatever. But you know what? It ain't no way around that he will die.
That's right.
Abner didn't want to do it, but because David was the king, he obeyed King David.
That's right.
Showed up. He sent the letter by Uriah himself. How cold can you get?
My God.
Sent the death letter in the man's hand.
My God.
That he wanted to have killed.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all don't hear me. Added sin to sin. And although David was a man that ran from Saul all those years, and he had been with God, and God had showed him so much about him and how he delivered David out of all these different situations, but yet David's heart turned just that quick in the wrong direction because of one woman. And when he had Uriah killed, he took the woman and married her for himself and thought he was getting away. But one thing about sin, you may get by, but you won't get away.